Well, let's talk about it. The biggest story to happen, you know, the other day we had a big story with Jeff Hardy and we were covering it and things were happening as we were recording. And then the other day it just happened with this Vince McMahon news, and it's been kind of a downpour now of news about WWE and behind the scenes things going on.
Things going on. As things going on, we don't know. It came out, what, as I said, not even 48 hours ago. The first story was that Vince McMahon was being investigated by the WWE Board of Directors for an improper relationship and subsequent payoff and NDA non-disclosure agreement being signed with a former employee who apparently was hired and then got an upgrade in the job and a raise and then was given to John Laurinaitis as an assistant and then left the company. She worked there for, what was it, 2 years. The first year she got $100,000 a year. Second year she got $200,000 a year. And her severance pay was $3 million. $3 million. Apparently that was a settlement for her to go away and not talk ill of anyone. And all I got to say is, if I ever pay anybody $3 million to not talk about me, you can be absolutely positive that I did whatever they said that I would do if I didn't pay them. What the? So Vince being investigated by the board of directors for improper relationship with a former employee, Laurinaitis is involved also. The investigation is on. That's the first news we heard, right?
The first news we heard was an article from the Wall Street Journal went up and it was posted on social media. And that was the first mention yesterday afternoon that right after the close of the market, that the board is investigating the secret $3 million settlement that Vince McMahon paid a departing employee, and then there were other details in the article to the story.
Well, and apparently, and we'll try to break all this down, but apparently that this agreement that was signed with the NDA barring discussion, she was hired as a paralegal in 2019, and like I said, was there for 2 years, and then does it say whether she was let go or I want to leave? How much are you going to pay me to go quietly? What do we know what the arrangement there was?
I'm not exactly sure. One of the things that really stuck out to a lot of people in this article in the Wall Street Journal was a quote here from the friend of the woman who took the payout, right? I don't know if that's the way to put it, the woman who got paid to leave WWE $3 million. And here's the quote. My friend was so scared she quit after Vince McMahon and lawyer Jerry paid her millions of dollars to shut up. The initial email to the board said, referring to McMahon's longtime lawyer, Jerry McDivitt. But then the other one here was, there was a specific quote about the friend being passed to John Laurinaitis like a toy.
Oh, yes, yes. John Laurinaitis is described in the Wall Street Journal article. Well, actually, because of his biography on the WWE website, describes him as one of Mr. McMahon's most trusted associates. And the friend who sent the friend of the offended woman employee who sent an email to one of the board members that started this whole rock rolling down the hill, said that, yes, that after she worked for Vince, that then, the email to the board, here's the quote, also alleged that Mr. McMahon gave her like a toy, unquote, to Mr. Laurinaitis to be his assistant. Apparently, and here's the thing, this was a couple of years ago. Vince is 76 now. He would have been 70 fucking three. This woman is 41 years old, apparently. She was initially hired at the salary of $100,000, but it was increased to $200,000 after she began a sexual relationship with Vince, and then he gave her to Laurinaitis. And she worked for him for a while, And then the only thing, my friend was so scared, she quit after Vince McMahon and Lawyer Jerry paid her millions of dollars to shut up. If somebody I was working for paid me millions of dollars not to talk, I wouldn't quit. I'd stay there and see what else I could figure out to get paid to not talk about. But anyway, the directors apparently received a copy of the $3 million agreement from one of Mr. McMahon's lawyers on June 12th. It provided an upfront payment of $1 million with the remaining $2 million to be doled out over a period of 5 years. So, Vince and Mr. Laurinaitis, that was the initial story that came out. They're being investigated. They've already also, there's the board's 8 independent directors have retained New York-based law firm Simpson, Thatcher, and Bartlett, at least Les has got work, to conduct the investigation. But I understand now, not only are they investigating this one, but also previous allegations and or NDA agreements that were signed over the same type of tone of offenses with different people that involve Vince and or Laurinaitis and or other people. Is this what I'm hearing also? There's other NDAs and payoffs in the past that are being looked into.
There's a lot of questions everyone has. The Wall Street Journal article, one of the last things in there was it said that investigators learned of other non-disclosure agreements involving allegations against McMahon and Laurinaitis. And this is where it could get really interesting because, you know, one of the interesting angles of this case is it's Vince McMahon's money. It wasn't company money, the $3 million. However, the 100% raise is company money. That's where it becomes a very interesting dynamic there, because that's shareholder money. And I think, well, go ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, you know, yes, it is his money that he paid the NDA business with. You're correct. It is. They just took this woman who was hired as a paralegal for $100,000. And then a year later, oh, let's give her $200,000. And then let's give her this money not to talk. I would think, I'm kind of offended. I would have thought that if anybody was going to get paid by the WWE not to say things, it would have been me. But unfortunately, I guess I didn't do the right things when I was there. But so now...
Yeah, you can't say anything to damage the stock. What did Vince say? What was Vince's condition? And what did Vince say in bed? What was he whispering?
Oh, my God. But anyway, so this comes out, this announcement... And there's been other NDAs that they're going to be investigating and other settlements and payoffs. And there's more than one investigation from more than one law firm because the board of directors is investigating. But now also the stockholders are trying to conduct an investigation of any kind of impropriety, sexual or otherwise, that's been going on in WWE management. That was a thing that happened.